Sliding the tandem axle group along a trailer to adjust the weight on each axle group is an essential part of a truck driver's job. Understanding the positions of the axle on a tractor trailer is extremely important, as axles play a large role in making sure you are hauling safely and legally. In this video, we will explain how tandems work and how to slide tandems on a semi-trailer in 15 simple steps. Most tandem axles can be moved forward and backward along the length of a...
Este video es de cómo ajustar los ejes a la trailer. Se moverlos para adelante o para atrás conforme esté el peso del truck y trailer. Por ejemplo, si el eje del... los ejes del tractor, los de atrás del truck, tiene más de 34 mil libras... Hablando de Estados Unidos, tiene por ejemplo 34,500. Le mueves unos 2-3 hoyos a la trailer, moviendo los ejes para adelante. Significa reverseando un poquito para atrás. Los ejes, como están brequeados, se mueven un poquito para adelante. 2-3 hoyos y ya el peso queda bien, porque los ejes de la trailer no deben de tener más de 34 mil libras acá de este lado. Los del camión tampoco. Y los de enfrente no deben de pasar de 12,500. Continuamos.
Most tandem axles can be moved forward and backward along the length of a trailer to ensure proper weight distribution on the tractor and trailer axles. Many semi-trailers have sliding tandem axles that are mounted directly on the frame rails under the trailer. When the weight of a load is being hauled is unbalanced, a driver can transfer the weight by sliding the tandems either backwards or forwards. Remember to always slide toward the problem. If there's too much weight on the truck axle, slide the tandems forward so more weight is placed on the trailer axles. This is done by reversing while the tandems are unlocked. Likewise, if there's too much weight on the trailer axles, slide the tandems backwards so more weight is placed on the truck axles. This is done by driving forward while the tandems are unlocked. Each tandem hole accounts for approximately 250 pounds of weight transfer, which means if you move the tandems back by one hole, you transfer 250 pounds to the tractor axles. If you move the tandems forward by one hole, you add 250 pounds to the trailer.
Bueno, como miras, te dice, si los mueves un hoyito, los ejes para adelante, estás transfiriendo 250 libras. Si lo mueves para atrás, estás transfiriendo, en la primera 250 libras, lo mueves para adelante, le estás transfiriendo a la trailer, pero si los mueves los ejes para atrás un hoyo, estás echando 250 libras al tractor. Porque, por ejemplo, mira, si las ruedas las retiras hacia atrás, el peso se va hacia el frente. Si las ruedas las arrimas hacia el troque, el peso se va para atrás. Ahí tiene la idea, ¿verdad? Continuamos.
15 basic steps to safely sliding tandems. Ensuring the tractor and trailer are straight. Set the parking brakes of the tractor and trailer. Make sure the air pressure is at maximum. Lock the power divider for maximum traction. Activate the trailer hold switch. This is also known as the trailer spring brake override switch. Pull the slider handle out, then lock in the retainer. Mark the hole you want the front locking pin to land. Shift the transmission to reverse. When operating a manual transmission truck, be sure the range selector is down or low slide. Release just the tractor parking brake by pushing on the yellow button. Back the trailer up, the tandems will remain stationary while the trailer moves. Set the tractor parking brakes and safely exit the tractor. Then check the position of the front locking pin. If the pin is where you want it, remove the sliding locking handle from the retainer. Allow the handle to go in. Shift into drive or reverse. Rock the trailer gently to ensure the locking pins are firmly seated and completely through the holes. Visually inspect that the pins are through the holes and the locking handle is all the way in. Unlock the power divider, deactivate the trailer hold switch. We hope this video has helped you understand how to slide tandems on a semi-trailer. Knowing how to do this correctly ensures that you are always hauling freight both safely and legally. As always, remember to subscribe to and follow Schneider to get more truck driving content.
Así es, amigos. Si tienen alguna duda, me lo dejas en los comentarios. Hasta el siguiente, amigos. Si te gustó el video, no olvides suscribirte. Hasta el siguiente.
To get more truck driving content.